Hi folks, and welcome to a Seneca Rising Omnath Locus of Creation card review for cEDH. It's a four-colored legendary creature, and that is really rare. For red, green, white and blue, you get a legendary elemental 4-4. Quite fitting. When Omnath, Locus of Creation enters the battlefield, draw a card, and this is gonna make it possible to go for food chain strategies. We're gonna talk about that later. Landfall. Whenever a land enters the battlefield under your control, you gain 4 life if this is the first time this ability have triggered. And if it's the second time, you're gonna get red, green, white and blue mana to your mana pool. So it's something of a ritual that is actually a lot of mana if you get a secondary land drop into play. That is actually gonna be pretty easy. You put a fetch land in play, you crack the fetch land and you get a secondary land and then you get the 4 mana. That is a big ritual. And if it's the third time, you're gonna deal 4 damage to each opponent and each planeswalker you don't control. So there's a lot of different abilities on this 4 mana cost 4 color identity commander, sans black. Now on the ETB, you're gonna draw a card, that is really good. You wanna have a card on your commander. However, 4 mana to draw a card and you can't repeat it, isn't that amazing? You're not gonna be able to sit and grind value with this thing. You're just gonna get something when you cast it and then you have to flicker it, kill it, or food chain it. So in my opinion, this isn't really an amazing card drawing ability, but it's a card drawing ability nonetheless. The put a land into play and gain 4 life is cute, but it's not something we can utilize with the lack of black. We don't have Ad Nauseam, Dark Confidant and things like that. Now it's gonna be good when you wanna go long games with your Sylvan Library, so it's something, but it's not good. But the ability to gain 4 mana whenever you crack your fetch land, that is actually pretty amazing. Rituals are always strong and should always be respected. When you can gain access to a lot of more mana, you can do some really explosive things. We have seen Dockside Extortionist create some really amazing plays. However, in the case of Locus of Creation, you need to pay 4 mana first to get your commander into play, and then you can play a fetch land from your hand and then gain back the exact same mana you've paid to gain this thing. So you basically cast this thing, you pass the turn, and then you can do some explosive things your next turn. But you want to have your rituals on a low CMC so you can do them early in the game. For example, Dockside Extortionist is only 2 CMC. Well, okay, Dockside Extortionist is actually a little bit OP, overpoweredly broken, so it's hard to compare the two. This is a commander access in the command zone and you can do the ritual thing a little bit all over the time. But in general, I think the ritual thing could be utilized in some really cool ways when you're gonna get some mana to interact during opponent's turns or when you wanna cast something really expensive. In order to figure out how functional this ritual ability is gonna be, you have to playtest with this thing. I've seen some Storm decks running Ramos as the commander, gaining the 10 mana as a big burst and then trying to storm off from that. And maybe Omnath could perform something similar. It's a lot easier getting the mana from this thing. You pay 4 mana, cast your commander past turn. In your second turn, you play that fetch land, you gain a huge burst of mana, and from there you might be able to storm off in some form of way. But if this is actually gonna be cEDH viable, I'm currently skeptic. I was never really impressed by the Storm decks that Ramos produced. And the last ability to deal 4 damage to all opponents' face and basically board wipe planeswalkers is cute. Sure, there are some planeswalkers in this format that are actually seeing play. For example, Narset Padre of Veils, we have Ashok, and sometimes a few others. And this commander could be really good at just wiping away all of those. Getting 3 landfalls isn't that tricky. You basically put a land in play, crack that fetch land, and then find an extra land drop somehow. But in general, I view that board wiping planeswalker ability as something of a bonus. Currently, I actually think Bruce and Thrasius might be stronger than the new Omnath Locus of Creation, but we'll see how much that ritual ability performs. But I think it's time to look at food chain, because in comparison to the Thrasius, Omnath can actually go for food chain combos. So let's actually explain how that works. So if you have infinite mana from food chain, by exiling and looping the 3 available food chain creatures, you can infinitely cast Omnath Locus of Creation. You cast Omnath, you get a trigger to draw a card. Then you send Omnath into exile with the food chain back to your command zone. recast it infinitely and basically draw your entire deck. And from there you have your entire deck in your hand. You can do basically whatever you want. And with the color identity of red and blue, we have access to Mist Hologriffin and Squeed Immortal, which means we can play all three food chain creatures. However, we don't have access to black, which is the strongest food chain color, except for green, of course. You have to have green so you can actually play the food chain. But the trick is this: you cast, let's say, Demonic Consultation, and you name food chain. Now, during the dig, when you're exiling cards from top of your library, until you hit food chain, you are probably going to exile one of the three food chain creatures during your pathway. So they will end up in exile with food chain in your hand. So with Tainted Pact or Demonic Consultation, you have a card that is basically assembling the entire combo. But we can't play this because we're lacking the color identity of black. Because of that, I don't really see a big reason why you should play Omnath, the Sands Black, when you can play the first sliver, access to all five color identities. With black, you can have Tainted Pact and Demonic Consultation, and then also include Faza's Oracle as a secondary two-card combo next to as a plan B to your food chain. And when you compare the first sliver's cascade on cost with the Omnath's ETB draw card, it's not that big of a difference. Honestly, if you're looking for a food chain commander with a huge card drawing capacity, I think you should look at Niv-Mizzet Reborn. Also, access to all five color identities can win the game from food chain. There are some different tricks you need to do. You need to include some multicolored cards to make it functional. But on the ETB effect, you're going to draw somewhere between 1 to 4 cards. That is a lot more compared to what Omnath Locus of Creation is going to give you on cost. I don't think Omnath has that much going for it, sadly. Now don't get me wrong, this is probably gonna be able to put together something of a decent, functional, okay-ish commander. The problem is that we already have so many other, better commander options. And the only thing that is standing out with this thing compared to everything else is that secondary landfall trigger, gain 4 mana. As of now, it's really tricky to actually evaluate how strong and functional that ritual land drop is going to be. I think there might be some form of build, some form of deck recipe we can put together that is going to perform a little bit stronger compared to Ramos, but quite similar. Deck brewing, playtesting, and experimenting is going to showcase just how functional that is going to be. So as of now, this fourth version, this four color identity, I guess in the future you're going to make a fifth Omnath with all five color identities. That might be amazing, but this current version isn't really impressing me that much at the moment. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. If you like what I do and you wanna support me, feel free to share my videos or even checking out my Patreon page. Also, purchasing cards from the TCG Players website using the affiliate link in the description below of the video will also help the channel grow. So a big thank you to all of you.